Welcome to Life Journey. I'm your host, The Office McPherson. And today I'm dealing with the mystery of the Magi. The mystery of the Magi. Now, other individuals have mentioned that, or through history, or through every Christmas, we hear that the Magi was three wise men. But the Bible did not indicate that they were three wise men, but the Bible indicate that there was wise men. So the Bible saying, and after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who was been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and come to worship him." Now, many, witches are describing that these men was observer of the stars. So they must be magician or they must be witches. My friend, these was not witches or they was not, glory to God, magician. Now, when I've heard this, he was disturbed and all Jerusalem with him when he had called together all the people and chief priests and teachers of the law. He asked them where the Christ was to be born, in Bethlehem of Judea. The reply for this, that the prophet was written, "But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by mean least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will be shepherd of my people Israel." Then Herod called Magi secretly and found out from them exactly the time the star had appeared. He sent them Bethlehem and said, "Go and make careful search for the child. As soon as you have found him, report to me so that I too may worship him." Now his intention was not to worship Jesus. His intention was to kill Jesus. So who are the mystery of the Magi? The mystery of the Magi, they were not magician. They were not sorcerer. They were not witches, my friend. Hey, glory to God. So let's cancel those thoughts of these Magi. They were not three, because the Bible did not indicate that there was three Magi, but they say there was Magi, but the Bible didn't indicate that. That was guessing of who were these Magi. The mystery of the Magi. After Jesus, listen, on coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother, and they bowed down and worshiped him. Glory to God. Then they opened their treasure and present with him gifts of gold and incense of myrrh, and having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, but they returned to their country by another route. So these men was godly men. These men were not men as we witches might think, or they say that they was great magician. These men was, glory to God, men from Yen, men from Judea, men that studied the scriptures. Hey, glory to God. So after Jesus was born, wise men came to him, probably from the area which is now in either Iran, Saudi Arabia, or Yen, although they were often called three wise men. The Bible does not give the indication that there was three. Hey, glory to God. It's a wise man. And the reason why people say that there was three, because they had myrrh, frankincense, and then gold. But they were not, glory to God, magician. They were not, glory to God, wise men as we would say that they are. But they were not. I'm going to tell you, give you an indication of the mystery of the Magi. Glory to God. The mystery of the Magi. And I have three reasons, glory to God, why they were not, glory to God, as you would think that these men were scholars. These men was reading of the Word of God, and they came to the conclusion that Jesus would be born. And they brought the king, glory to God, they brought, glory to God, the king of Israel, a child. So the king Herod got upset. Hey, glory to God. He got upset of saying that, listen, bring me back word. And the reason why to bring back word, because the prophecy was fulfilled in Jeremiah, glory to God, that Lema, that Rachel's children, and what Herod did, he killed all, slaughtered all the kids, trying to figure out where would this Jesus be born. So I'm telling individual, my friend, we gotta be very careful how we put in things in the scripture and trying to find out whether or not these magi mean magician. These magi mean they was witches. No, listen, these men were not witches. These men were not magi, but these men was Hebrew of the text of scholars. They were following the word of God, and the word of God, glory to God, saying that a child shall be born in Bethlehem. So I hope this y'all help you to indicate that these magi was not magician, and these magi was not witches, but these magi was servant of the Most High. These were scholars. These was Jewish scholars that came, and the scripture will fulfill. And that's why I don't understand people. Glory to God. I don't understand people, glory to God, that draw the conclusion that the Bible, glory to God, is a fake book. The Bible is a book of prophecy. The Bible is a book that Jesus Christ came, glory to God, and fulfilled the scripture. That's why when he got resurrected, he called the men, "Oh fool and fool of heart, didn't that the scriptures from Proverbs spoke about me?" And when the men, glory to God, eyes were opened, they knew that it was Jesus. So I'm telling individuals out there that if you believe that these men was magicians, these men were witches, I'm going to say like Jesus Christ said to the men that was going toward, and they're saying that this is the third day and he is risen. And Jesus Christ said, "Oh, fools of heart, didn't you believe the scripture that was all spoken to me from Psalms and the prophet, that Jesus Christ should be crucified and raised the third day?" So you are a fool if you're going to believe that, glory to God, these men are magicians. These men, glory to God, are witches or magicians. These are not magicians. These was men of the scripture. These are men that came from Arabia. These are wise men. Hey, glory to God. A wise man is not a man that, glory to God, got to be a witch. A wise man is not a man that's illusion. Illusion, my friend, ain't got nothing to do with the scripture. There's no way in the Bible, except Simeon, he was a magician. He duped the people. He called himself a great one. But the Bible say that, glory to God, when he heard that the people was being healed, he tried to buy the gift. Hey, glory to God. And Peter say, you know, gall of bitterness. And he repent of his sin. And the same witch man, Simeon or Simon, he came to conclusion that I need this power called the Holy Ghost. And he put away, glory to God, his witchcraft. Because in those days, they called him a great one because he was a magician. He duped, the Bible say, he duped the people. He charmed the people. So these wise men, these magi, glory to God, are not witches, and they're not magician, and there was not three. They might have the gift of frankincense and myrrh and gold, but it doesn't indicate how many men there were. And these men was probably from Arabia or Yemen, my friend. These men was wise. These men searched the scripture. These men was knowing that the scripture say that this child gonna be born in Bethlehem. So I hope this helped, glory to God, to break the the myth of these men was magician, or these men was witches. I hope you enjoy. God bless you. Amen.